tables, but it's a slightly more convenient way of writing the truth tables. So they are similar to truth tables, but they lead to what are called graphical methods for Boolean expression simplification. So far we have used Boolean algebraic expressions directly, but corner map is a very interesting way of graphically or visually combining various terms together, and it will give you something which is with which you can minimize the Boolean expression. So the way corner map works is, for each min term we are going to assign an entry or a cell in the table. So we are going to build something called a corner map table, and for each min term we will assign one location in the table. And so if you have three inputs, then you know that the truth table has eight different combinations. So the corner map for it will also have eight different cells, and the cells contain the information of the function for the corresponding min term. So if a corresponding min term turns on, and then the function will turn on. So we will see how to capture this information in the corner map. So corner map for one variable essentially looks like this. So if I have only one input A, then A can take two combinations, either A can be 0 or A can be 1. I can write it in this row form. So A can be 0, so corresponding to this you will put the entry M0, and corresponding to when A equal to 1 you will put the entry M1. So you can either do this, or you can write the corner map like this. So for row, so M0 corresponds to row 0 and M1 corresponds to row 1, and this part captures whether A is 1 or 0. So when A is 1, you go and look at what is the value for M1. Similarly in this one, when A is 1, the value of M1 tells you what the value of the function is. If you want a two variable K map, we have F of A comma B. So in this case A, the possible values of A are listed in the rows, and possible values of B are listed in the columns. So in this case we go in the order 0, 1, similarly 0, 1 here. So 0, 0 corresponds to minterm 0, 0, 1 corresponds to minterm 1, 1 and 0 corresponds to minterm 2, and 1 and 1 corresponds to minterm 3. If your function is AB, you can also use the combinations of A in the columns and combinations of B in the rows. So in this case A is listed along the columns, so as you move from one column to the other A takes different values. So in this column A is supposed to be 0, in this column A is supposed to be 1, in this row B is supposed to be 0, and in this row B is supposed to be 1. So if you notice the minterms here versus the minterms here, they are only shuffled slightly. So M00 and M11 are in the same place, 01 and 10 have moved to a different locations because A and B are swapped in the directions. And a three variable K map is let's say is a function of ABC. So we have taken one of these variables, namely A, and we list all the possible values that A can take, namely 0 and 1. And for each row you list all the possible values that B and C can take. So BC can take 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 or 1, 1. But as I said earlier, we will in the previous module I mentioned this, we will instead of having 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, we will keep it as 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1 and 1, 0. We will see why this is so in a little while, and the corresponding min terms are here. If you notice, this row corresponds to A equals 1. So these four min terms, M100, M101, M111 and M110, you can see that we are looking at A in the uncomplemented version in each of these four terms, and B and C are coming in all possible combinations, right. So this row corresponds to A equals 1, and this row corresponds to A equals 0. If you go and look at these four entries here, so you go and read it, M011, 010, 111 and 110. If you notice, the second bit is turned on, right, which means for B equals 1, these are the four min terms that capture the fact that B is 1, or it is going to be in the uncomplemented form. And similarly, if you take these four, this captures the information that C should be 1, or C is in the uncomplemented form. You can see that 001, 101, 011 and 111 has the last bit C, which is 1. So this is a three variable K map. You can, so here I have chosen A to B along the rows here and B and C along the columns. You can also do a slight different rearrangement. In this case C is picked to be along the rows, and combinations of A, B are along the columns. So correspondingly, the minterms will also get shuffled. So 0, 0 with 0 gets 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 with 0 gets 0, 1, 0, and so on. So we should not read from rows going into columns, we should read from columns going into rows, because we have fixed the order to be A comma B comma C. So we should read the bits for A first, then B, then for C. So this cell is corresponding to A equals 1, B equals 1, and C equals 0, or M6. And 4 variable K-map is essentially list all the combinations of 2 inputs along the rows and another 2 inputs along the columns, and the only difference is you see 0, 0, 0, 1, a 1, 1, and a 1, 0, as we did in the previous example. So in the 3 input case, we had 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. We will list them in the same order here, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. The same thing for C and D, which are the 2 other inputs, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. So in this table, the last 2 rows correspond to the fact that A should be 1, or it corresponds to A being uncomplemented. The middle 2 rows correspond to the fact that B is uncomplemented. The last 2 columns correspond to the fact that C should be uncomplemented, and these 2 columns for D to be uncomplemented. So this picture here is essentially just picking CD for the rows and AB for the columns. So you can see that if I pick this cell, the function says it's in the order ABCD. So to say what minterm should go here, I should look at AB here, which is 0, 1, and CD here is 0, 1. So this is M0, 1, 0, 1. If I look at this cell here, this corresponds to A equals 1, 1, and AB equals 1, 1, and CD equals 0, 1. So this is M1101. So that's what we have here. So these 2 tables are actually equivalent, only that the order in which A, B, C, and D are picked are different here. Let's see why the whole thing is useful. So all this thing that I showed so far doesn't really help you in doing anything better. So it's only just the table rewritten in a different form. However, let's see how we can actually use K-maps to simplify things. So let's start with this one. F is A plus BC plus D bar. Let's see how this thing can be represented in a table. So remember, this function is having 4 variables, namely A, B, C, and D. And if I don't mention explicitly, we'll keep the order always in increasing alphabetical order, A, B, C, D, X, Y, Z, and so on. In this case, we'll assume that the function is written as A, B, C, D. I'm going to take A, B along the rows and C, D along the columns. So you have A, B, the 4 possible values, C, D with the 4 possible values, with this little twist. We go 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. Similarly, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0 here. Now let's see these 3 terms. So like we did with the truth table in previous module, I'm going to go and fill up this K-map table with ones and zeros. So the first term is A, right? So if A is 1, no matter what B, C, and D are, F will become 1. And to capture that, right, so this is a place where A is 1. You can see that AB, you put 1, 1 here and 1, 0 here. So this corresponds to A equals 1, because that's a row where A is 1, and so are all these entries. If I look at all the entries here, they all correspond to A being 1. So B is of course taking 1 or 0, we don't care about that. So if A is 1, all these terms, right, correspond to the minterm where A is 1. So all these are the minterms where A is 1. Finally, let's look at BC. Let's find out all the minterms which correspond to B equal to 1 and C equal to 1, right? So if you go and look at this column here, so B is 1 and C is 1. So this is a minterm which corresponds to B equal to 1 and C equal to 1. But that is not the only place. All these 4 cells correspond to B equal to 1 and C equal to 1. So you go and look at this. This is a row in which So these are the rows in which B is 1. These are the columns in which C is 1. So the intersection of that is these 4 cells. So these 4 cells correspond to the fact that B and C are both 1. Finally, let's look at D bar. So if D is 0, F should be 1, right? So wherever D is 0, we are going to mark. So we need a 1 there. So let's see. So if I look at this column here, we know that it's CD, where C corresponds to 0 and D corresponds to 0. So this must have a D bar, and so will this, this and this entry, because all of that corresponds to D being 0. Similarly, if I go and look at the last column, this also corresponds to D equal to 0. So this corresponds to C equal to 1 and D equal to 0. We do not care about the value of C when we look at this term here. So all those entries also become, they are all corresponding to the fact that D should be 0. Now wherever you see something like this, so this is true when A is true, this is true when either A is true or BC is true, this is true only when BC is true, this is true only when D is 0, and so on. So wherever you have some entry, you make all of them ones, because that is what the truth table tells us. You can see that, right? So in this, in for example, in this cell, A is 0, so this is 0, B and C are both 0, so this term is also 0. However, D is, if D is 0, this cell should get a 1. So this is having only the information that D bar should be 1 for the cell to be become 1, and in this specific case D bar is actually 1. So wherever we have some entry, we make all of them once. We do not need the sum terms anymore, we do not need the product terms anymore, we can drop it. All the terms that are not there, they become zeros. So these three entries are zeros. So if I go and write the truth table for this function, it will have 2^4 or 16 rows. Among the 16 rows, 13 rows will have a 1, and the rows corresponding to these three min terms will have a 0. You try it out. So I put it in the k-maps table. You go and put it in a regular truth table where you have 16 different rows with 4 combinations, and you will notice that minterm 1, minterm 3 and minterm 5 will be zeros if you expand this function. All right, so you go and try that out yourself. So let us see how k-map is drawn. We start with, so in this example, A, B and C, D are switched around, the same function, but A, B and C, D are switched around. So first, A is true for these two columns, then BC is true for these 4 cells, and D bar is true for these 2 rows. And we can do the same thing that we did before. Wherever you have an entry, you put a 1, and wherever there are no entries, you put a 0. This is also a valid K map. So this is essentially a different way of folding the same truth table. So far what we have is, the truth tables and k-maps are not different things, they capture the same functionality, except that the truth table will have a single vector for the column. So you will have one output vector, which is the last column. However, in a k-map, the ones and zeros are actually embedded inside either a square or a rectangle or something like this. So in this case, we have to pick the ordering of the inputs, and based on that we put the min terms correspondingly.